1948 presidential election provided one of the greatest upsets in U.S. history. Thomas E. Dewey was chosen to be the Republican standard bearer for the second time. And the Democrats chose Harry S. Truman, the man who had succeeded to the office on the death of Franklin D. Roosevelt. From the day of Mr. Truman's nomination, the experts were saying that the man from Independence, Missouri, didn't have a chance of beating Dewey. However, Mr. Truman, along with his running mate, Alben Barkley, had different ideas about his chances. Through the long, hot summer, the two candidates stumped the nation from coast to coast. As election day drew nearer and nearer, the odds on a Dewey victory grew longer and longer. All the political analysts began to believe it, all except the candidate himself. More than 48 million voters flocked to the polls, the greatest number to that time, and when the early returns filtered in, it began to look as if the experts were right. Dewey was in the lead. Yours truly, right center, was in the midst of the action that night when some newspapers scrambled to make themselves look silly. The president rode back into office on the basis of returns from Ohio, a state that Dewey had won 4 years before. It was 11 o'clock the next morning before Dewey conceded, and later the president attended a victory dinner. He mimicked a radio commentator and he brought down the house.
And I went back to bed and went to sleep.